All right. Welcome back, everybody. It's Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming live from Portland, Oregon, trying to break it all down on the West Coast. People, we are excited. I don't know if we got you guys. We are happy right now as Duck fans. We're in a whole new world right now. Ducks are hosting a Super Regional this weekend. It's baseball season. This is a baseball school now. If you guys know my shtick, most of the time I stick to the script. I talk about football. You know, I talk basketball too. I love Duck basketball. And my dad played at Oregon as a baseball player. I've loved Oregon baseball. I've admired Oregon baseball for years. And I'll talk a little bit more about that in a second when I get kind of breakdown on this thing. But again, sit back, relax if you got time. If you're in the car or wherever else you're joining me, I really appreciate it, man. I tried to build this little program here. We've got over now over 10 years of talking into a computer. It's been a Mac the whole time, baby. I'm Team Apple. I don't know if anybody else is out there. computer wars. My son is not. My son likes the PC, but I'm excited as hell for this. This is a huge deal for Oregon, and we got to break this down. So again, if you are just joining the channel for the first time, thank you so much. If you guys are interested in football, I cover football. I cover the hell out of the football in the fall, and we'll get into it. But this is kind of the off season. It's June, it's ready to be summer. I'm a teacher. I got 2 weeks to go. It is full-blown summer mode right now. So we are excited, and we got to talk about this game. So let's go ahead and break this thing down first and foremost. If you guys are interested in baseball and you like the Ducks and, you know, you like Duck baseball and you go to games, then, you know, obviously what I'm going to be talking about is fairly basic because you know the drill. But a lot of people don't. A lot of people are, you know, kind of, you know, one, I think baseball's some sort of a dying sport, at least across the country anyway. I think from its heyday, probably just after the war to, you know, World War II to now, I think it's really, really, you know, kind of declined over time. I think that's also because, you know, you've seen sports like the NFL, you know, NBA also grow in popularity at an alarming rate as well. So, you know, I think that has something to do with it. But baseball, there's still the hardcore baseball people out there. There's still a lot of kids out there playing baseball. There's still a lot of high school baseball out there. And baseball still matters to a lot of people around the country. It's just, I feel like overall it could be a dying sport. And because of that, you know, you don't see that many people in the stands at PK. You know, early in the year, I had a friend of mine who teaches next door to me, and he's a Beav. He's an alumni. He's a baseball guy, baseball coach, you know, he takes his team down on a trip during spring break every year, and they wanted to take the team to a baseball game. They couldn't take the team to OSU because OSU's sold out for every game, damn near, or at least if that's not sold out, there's not a bank of tickets where you can get the whole team in there. They go to PK, and they could sit anywhere they wanted, basically. They could go anywhere they wanted. They were like, sure, you take 30 teams at this point. It's just like, that's just kind of how it goes right now. And again, that's not an insult on Oregon necessarily, but I think it's just an insult, you know, on, you know, the general watching population. They're not going to go in a cold weather, you know, environment to go out there and sit in the rain for two or three nights in a row and watch these games, unless you're a baseball fan, unless you have something else invested in the sport or the program. And so I grew up a baseball fan. My dad played at Oregon. My dad was a pitcher. And, you know, I've always loved and admired baseball. I grew up a baseball player. Baseball was probably my best sport. And, you know, I absolutely loved baseball. I was a stat guy. I had all the stats from all the, you know, history. I was a history guy. You know, I loved the game. I absolutely loved the game. I'm wearing, you know, Ebbets Field flannel. Shouts out to Ebbets Field. You know, this is a replica of 64 team. You know, I love gear. I love jerseys. I love all that sort of stuff. I grew up with that. And a lot of that came from baseball. And, you know, my dad had old Duck gear from when he was there. I used to wear that. He absolutely loved that stuff when I was growing up. And so to see the team really grow is really awesome. And, you know, this is a huge moment. This is a really shining moment right now for this Duck baseball program. This is a team that has kind of come out the mud, right? And you got to thank the guys who did this, right? Pat Kilkenny, Joe Gensante. Man, you got to give it up to big Joe Gensante, man. That guy has a huge, huge part of this, the sales pitch. But, you know, you couldn't do this without Pat Kilkenny. That's why his name's on the field. And, you know, you have a situation where you have, you know, an opportunity like this where it doesn't come along that often. They really worked hard for this, and they got themselves in a unique spot to get there, and they didn't come easy, right? They probably shouldn't have won the Pac-12 tournament. They won it. They probably shouldn't have won the regional. They won it. They should, you know, there's a variety of different things maybe they shouldn't have and they ended up doing and they ended up winning. So that's how it is in baseball. Sometimes it's one play that makes the difference. That's why you play a series oftentimes to try to eradicate that as much as possible. But, you know, I'm just so proud of this team. I've watched this team the whole year. I watched a lot of baseball and a lot of softball this year. I really got into the softball this year. But love this team. Was at the game at the spring game. I don't go to a lot of games in the spring. I'm a golf coach, so I can't really go and break it down that many times. But you know, I also go to the beach. You know, this weekend I was gonna go to the beach. Hey, now change the plans, boom, go down to Eugene. So super excited for this. It all goes back though, I really think that you have to go back to, you know, George Horton, right? That first coach. Coach Waz coming in as an assistant coach, working on here for 5 years, having an opportunity to really kind of see the program get built and what that means to the university. The way that it's rounded out, I think, is absolutely beautiful. And now they got a really good shot. They have Oral Roberts coming to town. And, you know, I think, again, this is the way that it plays out. You know, it's not a super heavy hitter team, you know, a blue blood necessarily. Still a really good team. Don't get me wrong. Anybody in the last 16 is a good team, but Ducks have a real shot here. Ducks have a real opportunity here, and they're hosting, and you got to love it. So, you know, let's go through some of this stuff really quick. First and foremost, I'm a Seattle Mariner fan growing up. Junior and Edgar and Jay Buhner, all those guys, Unit. And when they got Ichiro, I was already a fan, and my love of baseball and my love of the history of the game is universal, man. And I have kind of fallen, I've said this before, kind of fallen out of love with baseball a little bit in the last maybe 10 years or so. I don't watch as many MLB games. I don't know as many players in the MLB. I don't watch as much of it. I don't consume as much of it. But I loved Ichiro, and to have Nishida, man, I'm telling you, Raikou is just such a great player. I love his style. I'm a left-handed player in the box. I swung left-handed, and when I saw Ichiro, I saw the kind of swing that I was trying to have. Any of the off-speed pitch, any of the stuff left to go left field, because go opposite field was kind of an art form. A lot of guys weren't really into that or whatever. And I looked at, you know, Ichiro's swing. I look at Raikou Nishida's swing, and I really see a lot of similarities there. Right fielder with a great arm, just a flair for the game. And I'm just so impressed with him personally. And the fact that he went out and got this national notoriety on a national stage and got the MVP for that regional, I was just so impressed with him. He's a guy who the moment I saw him play, he was my favorite player on the team. And normally I'm a first baseman by trade. I grew up first base my whole life. You know, obviously the biggest kid. I was always the biggest kid in my class. You know, I was one of the tallest kids, one of the biggest kids, strongest kids. You put that kid at first base. My coach in high school said, "You're building a front door. We need to put you at first base. You're stopping everything." And I love the game from first base. So of course I'm a first baseman by heart. I always loved the first baseman first. But you know, I really, really am a guy who is just fell in love with Raikou Nishida. So Jacob Walsh is the guy, first baseman, super good first baseman, great player, 6'4", 225, just an absolute stud, but like a linebacker. And, you know, you have some of these guys, they really hit the weight room. So let's go back to this thing, right? So I think the big change here was hitting the weight room a little bit more. And what Coach Waz said, great interview, John Canzano, shouts out to Canzano on the way home today. I was listening to it. And Waz was talking about how he got his own strength and conditioning coach. When he had the meeting with Rob Mullins and they asked what the vision was for this team, he said, "Hey, I need my own strength and conditioning coach that's just a baseball guy, and we're going to work just on baseball, and we're going to get this thing right." And I thought that was absolutely awesome. And so, you know, you can really tell this team really hits the long ball. You know, back in the day, George Horton era, they relied on more of the pitching. They were lower scoring games. You know, now where they're in a situation where they hit the long ball, it's just a lot of fun to watch. It's a better product. It's more of an SEC type product. And it's just been absolute blast. So let's go back to this weekend. First and foremost, the Pac-12 tournament was awesome. Super fun to watch that one. Had a big win there. They probably should have lost that one. Like I said, Stanford should have closed that thing out. But you know, they got themselves in a situation where they were able to win that thing, and then that got them into this tournament. They wouldn't even be here had they not won that Pac-12, and we know that because now the rest of the Pac-12 was treated, and the rest of the West Coast was treated, actually. There's a lot of teams on the West Coast that were omitted from playoffs, and so having this opportunity now for the Ducks, they got to capitalize on it. So, and then you have humongous plays happen, like Zaven Sabalas, you know, basically a catcher playing third base, absolute dime when you really needed it, an absolute clutch moment of the game, playing Vanderbilt, you're up 8-5, bases loaded, and it's a dribbler, it's a two-out game, you know, you or two-out inning, you have to have this out. Little dribbler, and these guys have all the momentum in the world, and this guy absolutely comes down the line, and this is one of my favorite plays in all of sports, not just baseball, in any sport. The short, off the bounce, catch the ball with just your bare hand and rip that thing to first. And from a first baseman's perspective, nobody I feel like has a better viewpoint of this play. You see the ball off the bat. You come to your bag, you see the whole thing come together, you see the art, the real art of the lean, push off that foot, rip that ball right down the line, and it comes right up into your glove. I think also Walsh did a great job of stretching out and really making the play. You know, this is a situation in baseball where it's not just the catch, it's not just the throw, it's also the next catch. And I thought that little precision right there was unbelievable. Sabalas also made another play like that, same thing in the Xavier game, but this was at an absolutely crucial point. They could have scored two runs right there. Had he thrown the ball over Jacob's head, it could have gone even crazier. I mean, this could have been a wide variety of things. And this, again, is a catcher, a 6'3", 225 catcher, ripping down the line and pulling a ball off a short hop and throwing an absolute dime. So I'm excited as hell, as you can tell. I was super impressed with how the bats came alive. You know, the announcers were talking about how they didn't think that really the bats were going to come alive in that final game, but the bats started to come alive for the Ducks. They started to pour it on. They beat Xavier every single time they played them this year. You know, the Ducks started the year off playing Xavier, first three games of the year, first four games of the year, and won all of them. They were close. They won all of them, and then to end the year like this, you know, is unbelievable. So it's gonna be an awesome atmosphere. If you can buy a seat, maybe off of a StubHub or SeatGeek or some sort of thing or whatever, but I think it's gonna be a packed house. I knew this was gonna be a hot ticket. They had the pre-sale at noon. I got in right at noon, bought the seats. Then they opened to the general public at 5. By 5:15, I only saw 4 seats left in the whole building. There might be some general admission seats out in right field, but I think PK is going to show up. I think it's going to be a beautiful weekend. Hopefully the Ducks get these wins, really go to the next level and take this thing to the next level. Again, I think you got to win with class. Of course, I know people love to pile on. The Ducks beating, you know, Stanford was awesome for that level, you know, a little bit. But also Stanford whooped the Ducks' ass in the regular season. The Beavs beat them in the regular season. Huskies absolutely torched the Ducks at the end of the year, if you guys remember that. I mean, that was absolutely horrible. I mean, those were just horrible games. They beat the Ducks one game 8-18. They scored 18 runs on them after they scored 14 on them the first night. So, again, I just you got to be able to kind of win with a little bit of class, and I think that the Ducks had a great year. They put themselves in this opportunity, but, you know, they did lose a lot of series this year, and, you know, they again, had they not won the Pac-12, they wouldn't even be in this situation anyway. So you're kind of playing with house money at this point, so let it rip. All right, guys, hopefully you guys will be able to come down and see the game in Eugene if you can. Hey, check it out, man. I'll be there. All right, y'all, Sports Chat 503. We'll see you guys. Adios!